It's empty in the valley of your heart. The sun, it rises slowly as you walk away from all the fear.
We use physics every day of our lives without even knowing it. Everything that we use is related to science or physics somehow. For example, when you shoot a basketball, you use physics to figure out how far it's going to go and where it's going to land. Or when you push something or jump off something, that's physics. Even your phone you use to text couldn't have been made without physics and science. So come on, take a look and see how we use physics every day.
Every time you play basketball, you use physics to figure out the trajectory of your shot. You can measure the height of your average basketball hoop any day. All you need is one of these and one of these. The unit of measurement we're using today is the meter. It's this, and it's equal to 3 feet. Okay, so all you do really to measure is you just put this up like this. This is 1 meter. Thumb up there. It's 2. And as you can see, this goes up to the arc, which is 3 meters to the arc. Now since the arc doesn't move up anymore, then this thing is 3 meters high. And 3 times 3 is 9, making it 9 feet. You can do it anytime.
And now, Luke Morse presents Athlete Man.
Get to the bottom of a slide, you don't move as fast as you did at the beginning? Well, it's all because of one thing, friction. As one thing moves against another thing, it loses energy. Physics! Next up, we're going to measure the length of this car in meters, same way we did the basketball hoop. There's one. There's two. There's three. Four. And 20 centimeters. The length of the car was 4.2 meters. Now using that, we can figure out how many cars it would take lined up bumper to bumper to get from point A to point B. Let's say the distance between point A and point B is 2 miles. Now things to keep in mind, the car is 4.2 meters long. 1 mile is equal to 1,609.3 meters. And since we need 2 miles, all you need to do is multiply that by 2, and you get 3,218.6 meters. Now all you need to do to calculate how many cars it would take, bumper to bumper, is divide 3,218.6 by 4.2. This is the total length, this is the car length. Now after you do the math, you get this number. Now since you can't have 0.33 cars, you round down. And since the meters cancel each other out, it's not meters, it's cars. So you need 766 cars to line up 4.2 meter length cars to get to 2 miles. Thanks to physics, we can also calculate the velocity of something. We're going to calculate the velocity of this tennis ball. Now, here on planet Earth, the acceleration of an object is 9.8 meters per second. It's different on other planets, but here it's 9.8. So when we drop it from 2 meters, we can calculate its velocity by multiplying 2 by 9.8, and we get 19.6 meters per second. So when I just dropped it, it was traveling 19.6 meters per second. Thanks to physics, we can also calculate the gravitational potential energy of the tennis ball. The gravitational potential energy is energy stored in an object due to gravity. Now all we do to calculate it is multiply the acceleration due to gravity, which is 9.8 on Earth, by the distance traveled, 2 meters, by the mass of the object, which is 0.056 kilograms. It's always in kilograms. And multiply it all together for a grand total of 1.092 joules, because energy is measured in joules. Thanks for watching my video.